everybody, and welcome back to the To-Do List. Show where we are striking off things off our creative to-do list, one thing at a time, while we're in self-isolation. So today on the to-do list, we are going to be creating a multi-layer stencil. So this was something that when I first started working on my own art projects, this was the first type of artwork I ever made. So what we're going to do is we are going to find our image. If you haven't seen my previous episode of the to-do list on bird watching, I really like birds. So for my image for my multi-layer stencil, I am going to do a bird. Specifically the black-capped chickadee, one of my favorite birds. Fun chickadee fact for you, the average black-capped chickadee has a heart rate of 480 beats per minute. The average human has about 60 to 100 beats per minute. That's crazy, isn't it? And that little cute tiny little bird inside its body, its heart is going what a hard-working little guy. That's nothing to do with the actual video, but it's kind of interesting. So, the first thing that we're gonna be doing is we're gonna be finding our image. I'm just looking on the internet for a picture of a chickadee. And then I am going to be tracing that image onto a piece of clear film. First, I'm going to start with the outline. That's going to be my first layer. So that layer I'm going to be spray painting black. And then I'm going to move on to the second layer. This layer is going to be all the areas that are going to be white. And the third layer, all the little areas that are going to be gray. Now we're going to start cutting out our stencil for all the areas that I'm going to need to have a crisp kind of straighter line. I'm going to use a X-Acto knife, and for all the areas that are going to require more of a natural looking edge, I'm going to use a stencil cutter, which is essentially a battery powered tool that heats up a sharp tip and it's able to melt through plastic. And now it's time to go outside, because spray painting in the house is stinky. And make sure, if this is ever something that you're going to try, make sure that you have some sort of respirator mask covering your face, because it's really not good to breathe in all the spray paint fumes. So I found this little piece of wood that I'm going to be making my bird stencil on. So now that we're outside, we are going to lay out our first layer, which is going to be our black outline layer. I'm going to be using these little chunks of tile that I use to weigh down the edges, because in order to get a crisp, clean line, we got to make sure that our stencil stays flush against the surface. So then we're gonna peel off our first layer and see how it looks. I think that looks pretty good. So then we are going to move on to our second layer, where we're gonna have our areas of white. So we're gonna line it up as best we can. We are gonna put those weights down on the edges, and we're gonna give it a spray with our white paint. I'm gonna throw a little bit of yellow in there, because when I look at my picture, I see that the chickadee has just the tiniest bit of yellow in that white area on its belly. I'm going to add a little bit of black to the belly of the chickadee, and that's going to give it the illusion of being rounded and kind of more three-dimensional. So now we're going to move on to our last layer, which is going to be our gray layer, and we're going to peel that one off and see how it looks. So I'm going to go in with a few paint markers. There's a little areas of embellishment that I'd like to make to put a little shiny spot on the eye, to do a little bit of extra detail on the foot, just a tiny little bit. So now that we've finished up all of our details and all of our layers, we are calling ourselves done. And we have a beautiful little bird. If there's no birds in your backyard, you can just look at this bird and you can have a conversation with it in case you're lonely. So I wanted to thank you for joining us on this episode of the To-Do List. I continue to look forward to hearing about all the things that you're doing in your own free time during isolation, and the things that you're crossing off of your own creative to-do lists. Thanks for joining me, and I'll see you next time.